Page 14 at midnight, I hear voices from the kitchen. I let my feet follow the sound as I let my ears listen. I walk upstairs and at the kitchen table I can see that God is sitting with the devil, sharing drinks and old stories. The floorboard creaks, a red embarrassment floats all throughout God's face. He swears that it's not what it looks like, then he swears he can explain. The devil speaks, your God and I put all our differences to rest. And a man's actions are his own, but men will blame us nonetheless. The devil stands, he grabs his keys and straightens out a rusted crown. He tells me hell is frozen over, heaven burned down to the ground, and you have only got one light, so do with it what you would like. We solemnly apologize, but we won't be there when you die. And I stand cold and alone in a body that won't move, watching the eyes of these gods that I once knew. One pair looks down in a half-hearted lie, while the other looks straight into my with the whole truth. Lacking the fear I've been told that God deserves, I say what good is a prayer that goes unheard. He says what hope could they find in a book if the book doesn't sell and the pages stay unturned. With a wink, the devil turns and exits the back door, and God is standing there in silence with